Yes. About that, then you send it again through the email. Then also send us through even WhatsApp. Okay. Now that Mori says he's sending another new link. The other one has it has an issue. But it's again setting to all the students so that they can log in using that one.
Okay.
Yeah.
That one will work.
Yeah, I think there's something that Shinga lost in terms of the setup. I don't understand their technical language. But the link he set now cannot connect between what we are doing and the YouTube.
Okay.
So I think you can also check there whether Morris has sent a link. He wants to post it there on the YouTube.
This one.
Anyone.
Okay.
He has to set up anyone.
All right.
And then the students can log in now using that new link.
So it means we have to inform them here?
Yeah, just tell them that the new link is being sent.
Okay.
That will be able to link us, the two systems. Yeah.
So, Daktari, can we log out and then you wait for the new link?
No, this one is not going to be affected.
Okay.
The link that is going to be affected is for the YouTube, not okay. This one.
Okay.
Yeah.
So has Morimi posted it there or not yet?
She has given them a message that we are going to change the link.
Yes.
I think we should wait. And he has apologized for the inconvenience. So I'm waiting to see the link and then we go there.
That's only for the YouTube, huh?
I think so. This one will not be affected, I believe.
No, this one is not.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so I think they have sent a new link.
Ah, okay.
Given them a message that we are going to change the link.
Yes.
But I think we should be waiting to see the link and then we go there.
That's only for the YouTube, huh?
I think so. This one will not be affected, I believe.
No, this one is not.
So the other link is working. I can see that we are there now.
Can you ask Murimi to... Murimi, can you also send it through my WhatsApp, please?
It has been sent, huh? Oh, it has been sent to...
Through WhatsApp, huh?
Oh, okay. Let me see.
So that new link, are you able to see the first slide here?
Let me see. I can see. No, they have sent a new link. Okay, so I'm not able to see this for YouTube. But they are joining. Have you got the link, Dr.?
Are you able to see that for that slide in the YouTube?
No. I can only see the logo, university logo, but this first slide is not visible yet.
I think the communication is, there's something that I think they really need to sort out. Because it seems that it is getting stuck somewhere.
I've shared the link with you, Dr. Mogaka.
Okay.
So I'm seeing there are 143 in the new link.
Good. You have shared through the WhatsApp?
Your WhatsApp. So I'm able to see the link, the slide, the first slide. So I think we are connected now.
Let me.
I think now our platform is connected to the online one.
How many students are there?
156. So I think they might take time to, we can start.
Who sent me that link again?
WhatsApp, your WhatsApp?
Yes. Or you send it through email?
I've sent it through the email.
Send it through WhatsApp, eh?
Sorry. Okay.
So, Murimi, are we good to go?
Yeah, I've sent you.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm not able to see this via YouTube.
Murimi?
But they are joining. Have you got the link? I tell you.
Yes, I have it now. Only that it takes a while before it transits from one slide to the other. Maybe this is another issue that that we need to address. So are you able to get me through the YouTube? If you are switched on.
Are you able to see that for that slide?
Yeah. The YouTube? I'm able to see it.
I can only see the logo, university logo, but this first slide is not visible yet.
I think the communication issues.
Huh?
There's something that I think they really need to sort out. Because it seems that it is getting stuck somewhere.
So, Dr. Moke, you can see this on the YouTube. Are you able to see this first slide of the logo?
No. I think it takes time to get...
But that is too long. You know, since I switched to this slide, it's like 3 minutes ago. Yeah.
I've shared the link with you, Dr. Mugaka.
Okay.
So I'm seeing down there, 143 in the new link. You are WhatsApp. So I'm able to see the link. The first slide. So I think we are connected now. I think now our platform is connected to the online one.
How many students are there?
156. So I think they might take time to, we can start.
Who sent me that link again?
WhatsApp, your WhatsApp?
Yes. Or you send it through email?
I've sent it through the email.
Send it through WhatsApp, eh?
Sorry. I've sent you.
Okay, so I'm not able to see this via YouTube.
Really?
But they are joining. Have you got the link? I tell you.
Yes, I have it now. That
that it takes a while before you transit from one slide to the other. Maybe this is another issue that that we need to address. So are you able to get me through the YouTube? Maybe you are switched on. Are you able to see that for that slide?
Yeah, the YouTube. I'm able to see it. I can only see the logo, university logo, but this first slide is not visible yet.
Let me get communication issues.
Good morning, everybody. I believe that we are ready to start. Sorry for the delay. It's because there were a few technical issues that were being sorted out. And, in case there's anybody who cannot get us here, please feel free to...
see this first slide of the logo?
No. I think it takes time to get...
That is too long. You know, since I switched to this light, it's like 3 minutes ago.
Mm.
Yeah.
I'm sure they will come here, Dr. Mugaka.
Okay.
So I'm seeing that they are 143 in the new link.
So I believe that now the system should be working. We can start, and sorry for the delay. Just one. So, good morning, everybody. Once more, let me say that we are sorry for the delay. This is a very serious delay of almost 40 minutes. That has not been always our practice. But being the first time, that we are also handling using this system, we are sorry for the delay. But we are ready now to start. And the first thing that I would like to say is that in case there is any student or anybody who would like to put a comment or there are questions that you need to ask, you are free to put them on the public chat. So my name is Hezron Mugaka, where we are going to start off the session for today. And basically the purpose of having today's session is to lay the foundation on how we are going to cover the course. So first of all, let me take this opportunity welcome you to the University of Embu, where, as you all know, is where knowledge transforms. And more particularly, we welcome you to the first semester of 2021-2022 academic year. So the first thing that we always do is that we believe so much as a university and also as individuals in prayers, because we know that everything that we do is through the grace of God. And the word of God for our students and for all of us as resource persons is based on Proverbs 18, verse 15, which says that the heart of the prudent acquires knowledge and the ear of the wise seeks knowledge. And you are actually in the right place where knowledge transforms. And we believe that your hearts are prudent enough to acquire the knowledge that we are going to offer for the session that you do in the university, not only for this particular semester, but for the 4 years that you are going to be with us. And remember also the second part of that verse says that the ear of the wise seeks knowledge. And therefore you are in the right place. And that's why we have to keep on thanking God for every gift that he has given us for us to be together. And we believe that our interactions as the as well as the learners is going to be useful. So at this particular moment, let me call the unit coordinator, Dr. Omoke, to begin the session with the word of prayer. Dr. Omoke. Dr. Omoke, it seems that we may also be having challenges to do with the technology, but let us bow down our head for a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we come unto you this morning, Father, in thanksgiving. We thank you for the bright day that you have given us. We thank you for the gift of life. And we also thank you so much for the student that you have given us. Our Father, we pray that for the time that they will be in the university, not only for this particular semester, but for the rest of the 4 years that they are going to be with us, you continue giving them good health, prevent them from this pandemic which is ravaging the entire world, Father. Give them good memories so that at the end of the day, whatever they are learning, they will put it into practice. And that we shall also continue rejoicing you for that. We also thank you for the learner, for the resource persons that you have provided us with. We pray that the interaction between the resource persons and the students, Father, is going to be useful and is going to create some transformation as the motto of the university is, Father. We shall forever continue thanking you and worshiping you. We pray all this, believing and trusting in Jesus' name. Amen. So, Dr. Omoke, welcome.
So much.
We have written up our prayer when it seems that the technology did not work in your favor.
Yeah.
So maybe, Dr. Omoke, I can give you a chance to introduce the resource persons, or I can do it from this end.
I can do it.
Please do.
Yeah. I'd like to note that the students joined very early and watched their communication. They were almost giving up, but these things happen. We pray for patience.
Good morning, everybody.
All throughout.
Once more, let me say that we are sorry for the...
So I'm going to take this opportunity to, because I've seen your concerns, just to highlight some of the things that have maybe answer some of the questions that you have raised. The unit coordinator, being supported here ably by Dr. Hezron Mogaka, and then I have my other colleagues, Dr. Eunice Musioka, Emis Kageni, Rosalind Nyaga, Nixon Mugendi, and we'll have also the library staff with us. So what happens is that each one of us will be in charge of particular groups, because I've seen some of you say that you have classes tomorrow and Wednesday. You are wondering where you are here today, but that one will be addressed. So for example, myself, Dr. Omoke, will be in charge of the BCom, Bachelor of Economics, and Purchase and Supplies Management. Dr. Mogaka will be dealing with two groups. One is Group B, Bachelor of Economics, Finance, Bachelor of Economics, Statistics, and then Bachelor of Finance. He will also be dealing with Group C, and these constitutes BSc IT, BSc Statistics, BSc Computer Science, BBIT, and then BMC. Group D will be, you will be assisted or facilitated by Dr. Eunice Musioka. And this is Nursing, Community Health, biology, AGED, that is agricultural education, analytical chemistry, industrial chemistry, biochemistry, microbiology, conservation, CBZ, and library and information science. Group E will be, Emis Kageni will be in charge of Bachelor of Education Science, and Group F is Rosalind Nyaga, Bachelor of Education Arts. Group G will be taken, you will be taken through by Nixon Mugendi, and this is the law, criminology, and Bachelor of Education Arts, English and Literature, as well as MPC. So I'm just giving an overview of how the course will be run. So majorly we'll be having our morning classes on Mondays, common lectures. And then for those who have classes on Mondays, we will be leaving 1.5 hours for you to meet your lecturers face-to-face. And for the face-to-face sessions, you will be required to participate there actively, as you will be advised by your lecturers. We have not done away with face-to-face classes. They will be there, but we'll be having common lectures where various topics will be delivered by the different people that you see here. There's one person I haven't mentioned, that is Brian Mlonzi, who I have co-opted to be assisting me. Since I'm the unit coordinator, I'll need him to be by standby to be assisting in some of the tutorial sessions. So for those who are in Group A, I will be introducing to you Brian Mlonzi at a particular time. So Dr. Mugaka, let me set the ground for you to proceed.
Okay, thank you so much, Dr. Omoke, for the introduction on how we are going to proceed. But obviously, what we expect is that the students, one advice that I'll give to the students is that please, when you come for these online classes, remember to carry your weapons. And the key weapon you need is a very good notebook and a pen, because it's important that you take note of what we shall be taking you through as part of communication skills or effective communication skills and as part of the learning process. So one thing that I would like to say as a way of laying the ground rules and food for thought is that a number of people believe, and a number of students, I believe, you think that success is a straight path. Success is basically complex, just like what you are able to see in the second diagram. The same way we talk about development, where we believe that development is a straight path, but it is complex. What we want to demonstrate using these two figures is basically that your time in the university, your moments in the university, and at the end of the day, your success is not going to be a straight line. It's not going to be linear the way you see it on this part here. But it is going to be complex. You are going to be faced with a series of challenges. And therefore, the most important thing that will determine whether you become successful or not successful is how smart you will be in terms of addressing any kind of challenge that you may meet, whether it's academic, whether it is social, whether it is health-wise. That is what will determine whether you're going to be successful. So let us not start our university education thinking that it's going to be smooth all the way, but we must be resilient enough. So that is a take-home message that we want as you as students to get right from the beginning, that your time here is going to be very complex. And please remember, you have now started writing your academic book. In terms of your career development book, you have started writing it. And this book is going to have several chapters. And the chapters in this case are represented by the different units that you are going to be exposed to by your resource persons. For example, this is going to be one of the chapters of your academic book, CCS 101. It's important that you have, right from the beginning, a very clear determination that the chapter on this particular CCS 101 and any other units that you are going to undertake should actually be an A. The worst case scenario should be a B. That is what will be create joy, not only within you, but also for your parents. Therefore, this is one thing that we needed to tell you, that your academic life, now you have started another phase of your academic life. It's going to be complex, but we believe that you will be able to go through it. And that brings us to basically telling you one or two things about the purpose of university education. What do you think is the purpose of you coming to the university? It's not just coming to get grades, but one thing is that you are going to be equipped with skills that will enable you to adapt to different sets of environment. And therefore, this university learning should be able to prepare you adequately on how to familiarize yourself with the worldly challenges and the challenges that you are going to face, whether in the country or in the world. But the key thing is that you need to familiarize with yourselves with the kind of challenges that you are going to face. But what's most important is not so much to dwell on the challenges, but to look at the existing opportunities that are given by any circumstance that you may come across. Any situation that you're going to get yourself into must be having a list of opportunities that you can exploit. Therefore, that means that you move away from lamentations and focus more on the opportunity that the university is going to present to you, so that at the end of the day, you'll be able to be a better person once you graduate. So that's one thing that we needed to leave with you, that you are here to be equipped with the skills that would enable you to adapt to different sets of environments, and therefore you should be adequately prepared to familiarize yourself with any kind of challenges that you'll be faced, and more important, to focus on the existing opportunities. The other thing that we need also to mention to you, what are our expectations from you as a student? We are lucky that we are interacting with all of you at Engo. One, we expect you to be punctual, including our resource persons, for all planned lessons, which, depending on your resource persons or the lecturers, will always start 15 minutes after the hour. That is to enable you move from one venue to another. But let me make it very clear that it's our desire that in the Monday morning classes, we actually start exactly at 7. So that means that you should be able to log in a few minutes to 7. But for the other subsequent classes, because you may be moving from, let's say, the TL venue to ABH, we can give you an allowance of 15 minutes to enable you to move from one venue to another. One other thing that we expect from you as students is to be very, very attentive, because at the end of the day, this is what will actually determine whether you write a successive chapter in your book or not. So whether you are online or whether we are going to be on face-to-face during the tutorials, it's important that you are attentive. The other issue that we expect from you is that you must be always in a learning mood or mode at all times, because you have decided, together perhaps with your parents, that for the next 4 years, you are going to be learning. And therefore, the best thing that you can do is that when you are within the sessions of the semester, please ensure that you are in a learning mode. The other aspect that we expect from you is to ensure that you actively participate in all the university activities. And for this particular unit, you participate both for online classes in terms of asking questions on the public platform, or during the tutorials, you should be able to engage with your resource persons, engage with your student, your fellow students, because we have said that this is the season for learning. This is the season for seeking knowledge. And we have already been, we have gotten it very clearly, the ear of the wise seeks knowledge, and the heart of the prudent acquires knowledge. So we expect you to be very active in terms of participating in the discussions, in the presentations of the unit. The other important issue that we persuade you to do is to dress neatly and decently, even when you are learning from home. Please ensure that your dress code reflects a kind of a person we expect as a future leader. Therefore, the dress code is very important. Dress neatly and decently. The other issue is that during the presentations and during the exchange of views through the platform, we expect you to observe some kind of decorum at all times. One other important thing that we would like also to tell you right from the beginning, when it comes to exams, you need to read the instructions very carefully, understand them, underline the keywords before you attempt any questions. Because many of us fail, not because we are not good enough, but because we have gone ahead and created our own questions apart from what the examiner has created. And then we provide the right answers for the wrong questions. And finally, what we expect from you is be a team player. When we are going to have you in terms of a team, I mean the groups, ensure that you participate as teams, because we may reach a point whereby we have to award you marks as a group. So this is what we call as the irreducible minimum, from number 1 to 8. Make sure you are punctual, be attentive, be in a learning mood or mode, be active in terms of participation, dress neatly and decently, observe decorum, and please read instructions and understand them before attempting any question, and always be a team player. So that is what we expect on the part of students, as your resource persons who have been introduced to you. Now we are gradually getting into what this unit is all about. This unit is on communication skills. What is the overall objective? Why are we going to spend time with you to take you through this unit? The reason why we are doing that is to help you develop a deeper understanding. And let me underline the word deeper, because already you must be having some level of understanding. Communication does not start when you come to the university. Communication must have started even when we were in our mother's wombs. So what we want to help you do is to develop a deeper understanding. And remember, this is what we shall be testing you against in both your CATs as well as the main exam. Develop a deep understanding, appreciation, and application of various communication principles, pathways, approaches, and foundations. So in other words, we want you to get out of this unit at the end of the season a better communicator. So that is the overall objective of having, for going to spend time with you in the, for the next 12 weeks or so. There's also what we call as the learning pillars, and this is something that you need to be very keen on, because if you master these 4 points, you start being not just a successful communicator, but a very successful leader in future. One, they are what we call as the learning pillars, there are 4 of them, is to motivate, to explore, to apply, and to create. In terms of to motivate, we are going to link you, or the way we are going to teach you is to ensure that we link you to day-to-day experience on efficient and effective communication approaches. This should be able to motivate you enough. In terms of exploring, we present the learners with the relevant empirical foundations on communication skills. And here, the boundaries we are going to set are going to be porous. And therefore, we expect you to explore beyond what the resource persons are going to expose you to. Because this is not one unit that you're going to stop using the skills that you're going to acquire at the end of the unit. But it is one unit that sets the foundation on how you are going to communicate your legal issues, how you are going to teach if you are the teacher, how you are going to prepare your financial statements if you are doing finance, how you are going to communicate with your patients if you are doing nursing. So it's a unit that will provide you with the skills that you'll be able to apply irrespective of which program you are in. And that is why we are offering it to all the programs. So the boundaries, we may not be able to teach you everything within the semester, but as we are saying, the boundaries we have set are going to be porous in such a way that you'll be able to explore beyond what we are going to expose you to. The other 3rd point is in terms of application. This is normally very important, because you realize that many of the questions, or 75% of the questions we are going to set in the CAT and in the main exam, will basically be application questions. And therefore, this is an important learning pillar whereby we provide you with opportunities to put into practice the communication concepts that you are going to learn. And this is the essence of going to have the tutorial sessions that we shall be having. We are going to explain how those tutorials, already Dr. Omoke has explained it, but we will expand on that. Number 4 is very important. At the university level, you must start developing a creative mind. We must promote creative thinking on the application of the key communication concepts. You must be innovative on how best you can communicate, because you are likely to encounter different situations, different people with different challenges, and therefore you have to be creative quickly on how can I communicate to this kind of audience so that we are able to go a long way. For example, if you find people who are already hunger in terms of food deficiency, how do you communicate to them? In case you go to a worshiping congregation, how do you communicate to that? In case you get to a community which is already angered for one reason or another, how do you communicate to that? In case you get to people, an audience that has got some kind of impairment, how do you communicate that? That is why creativity is very important, and it's a mind that will encourage you to continue developing, to continue sharpening. Therefore, these are the 4 key learning pillars that we have: to motivate, to enable you explore, to assist you apply, and also to enhance your creativity. So those are the 4 key principles that we expect you to sharpen with time. Now, the next issue is about the learning outcomes. An outcome is basically a transformation. An outcome is the change that you expect to see at the end of the day. And here, let me say that by us teaching 2,000 students, we can go into record that we delivered a lecture today to 300, 400 students. That's an output, but not an outcome. But how many of you would have probably acquired a knowledge that will be able to change you? That is what we call as an outcome. And then when it comes to the exams again, we shall test you on the change that we expected to create in you. So what change is this that we are expected to create in you? One, you should be able to articulate key communication principles and approaches. Number two, you should be able to develop short, comprehensive notes capturing particular moments. Number four, you should be able to develop short scientific notes on particular issues of interest. Number four is to draft logical speeches on matters of interest. And number five is to monitor and assess the effectiveness of communication approaches adopted. So this is not an end in itself, but these are, again, the minimum that we expect from you by the end of the session. Now, this next part is very important because we are going to explain to you how we are going to deliver the unit. There are four key areas that we are going to talk about. We are going to have interactive lectures. We are going to have individual and group presentations. We are going to have weekly group-based tutorials. And of course, there will be assessment. So let's go to number one. One point of delivering the unit is to ensure that we have interactive lectures. And this one, we are going to ensure that this can only be achieved if the students are ready, if the learners are ready to participate during the entire learning process. So as much as possible, irrespective of the numbers, we will try to be as interactive as possible. Number two, another approach we are going to use is to have individual and group presentations on take-home assignments and other related exercises, including the e-activities, which are already deposited in your portal. And every week, it's our intention and plan to ensure that we give you assignments that you are expected to undertake and then report back. And in the reporting, you can either do it as individuals or you can do it as groups, depending on the group and the size of the program. For example, when we are talking about the students taking Bachelor of Education Arts, you definitely have to go into groups. But if you talk about the students, taking library and information sciences, those ones, because the number is small, you are around 12 of you, you definitely have to present as individuals. And then whatever we are going to, the presentations will form part of the CAT marks. Now, in terms of the weekly group-based tutorials, here we want to request you to take the lead in terms of making presentations, in terms of leading discussions, in terms of clarifications. And that is why we are saying that every Monday morning from 7 to 10 a.m., we are going to have a common class which is delivered through this platform for all the students. So please inform any friend of yours who is not logged in, who has looked at the timetable, and the timetable may be confusing, to ensure that every Monday at 7, we log in and we have lectures through this platform for 1.5 hours. And then the other, or for 1.5 hours to 2 hours. Then the rest of the 1.5 hours, we will arrange that you get in smaller groups where you will make presentations. Now, let me clarify that, again, we stress the fact that every Monday morning from 7 to 10, there is no first year who has got a lesson anywhere. And please don't allow any of your lecturers who want to prepare for a makeup class to touch that slot. 7 to 10 is blocked for all first year students to take CCS 1 or 2. And again, it's your timetable, the timetable, you will see that it's written, for example, CCS 101B. It means it is that group B which the coordinator has spelled out who are the members in terms of programs to group B. And then after that, you see a figure which is written as 350. That means that is the total number of students for that group. And I believe that the coordinator, we are going to prepare a table which has got the groups, and then it spells out who are the members of each of the groups and the expected number of students. And then you may see that it's written TH144. The TH is tentatorium hall, although that is provided for in the timetable, but we shall be virtual. You can go sit there, have your classroom there virtual, but from 7 after the first session, your resource person may want you now to sit on a face-to-face to have a tutorial. And again, that TH you see, it's 144. That 144 is the carrying capacity of that hall during the COVID period. So you should ensure that we don't have more than 144 in that particular venue. So that is why we are having those details, CCS 101, let's say group B this morning, 350 are the students who are in that group, and then it's virtual. TH is the number of students who can be accommodated comfortably in that particular hall. And then from 3 today, you realize that there's another slot. So that means that all of you will actually have 2 slots in your timetable. There's the morning one on Monday morning, and then there are other slots spread across the week. For example, that group B, we are supposed to have a class from 3 to 6 at LT01, and we expect only 144 students. But because we have not yet isolated the 144, because it means that out of 350, it means we shall have different groups, the tutorials I propose we start next week. Then the other issue that we need to stress about is about assessment of students' appreciation, understanding, and application of the unit's objectives, principles, and application. This will be achieved through continuous assessment tests, which will constitute 30 marks, and then the final exam will have 70 marks. And I would like to say right from the beginning that you will have to take a minimum of 2 CATs, and then the main exam, which will constitute 30 marks, and then you get the average, and then the main exam will be out of 70 marks. We will try as much as possible to ensure that we mark the CATs in time, and then give you a feedback. And then the revision of the CATs will either be through this platform or through the tutorials. Now, let's get to the core of our business here, is basically to unpack the unit, what we are calling as unity description, or the content. So here, you'll be having 9-10 key entry points into this unit, which we are calling as the unit content or the unit topics. Topic number one will be the fundamentals of communication and collaboration. Topic number two will be on listening and not taking. The topic number three will be information literacy and ethics. Topic number four will be on oral skills, public speaking, including public speaking. which is very important. Number 5 will be study skills. Topic number 6 will be collaboration and interpersonal skills. Topic number 7 will be reading skills. Topic number 8 will be introduction to academic writing. Topic number 9 will be academic writing, where you really do the practice and try to communicate scientific academic information. And then topic number 10 will be collaborative writing. We believe that if we work as a team, as resource persons, and you as students, we should be able to achieve our objectives and, most important, making you better communicators. So that is basically the outline of the unit. Now, there's what we call as the planner or the tracker. And this one is very specific. And it's our desire that we stick to this program or the planner, but also even move ahead of time so that we can have plenty of time of interactions. So today, what was expected, I think we have done the opening prayer and the introduction of the unit. On 20th, topic 1, we expected to cover fundamentals of communication and collaboration. That will be at 7 in the morning. 27th, we do listening and note-taking. On 4th of October, we do information literacy and ethics. 11th of October, we do oral skills, public speaking. And we may need to cover topic 5, study skills. Then on 18th, I would like to take a bit of time to explain to you, and please talk to your friends. Part number 1 will be taken on the 18th next month from 7:30 to 8:30. Our cards normally take 1 hour. We don't expect any examination irregularity. When you get into the CAT room, you are not supposed, or in the examination room, you are not supposed to have any reference materials. You should not have your phone, whether switched off or whatever it is. You should not develop compound eyes. You start looking at what your colleagues on the sides or at the back are doing. That, if you do any of those, it will constitute serious examination irregularity. That will lead to, 1, cancellation of all the exams you have done for the semester. And that means you retake the units, or you'll be expelled, or you'll be suspended, or you may be forgiven, depending on the gravity of the situation. But remember, also, we have got CCTV cameras, where we are able to pick the conduct of every student during the examination process. So it's our desire that for this particular unit and the other units that you are going to undertake, you shall not have any examination irregularity. What we are going to do, and I hope you are taking notes of this, we are going to allocate you very specific venues, which we are going to do in the next 2 weeks, communicate to you, you have your admission number, and you have a specific venue where you will see it for that card from. And then you will do the same, you may use the same venue for the main exam. So let us not bring any confusion. If you are allocated venue TH, you make sure you do your card from TH. Because if you do from TH and you are not supposed to do from TH, your paper will not be marked. So that is very important. We shall give you the schedule, sitting arrangements, where you are going to sit for your card from, and the main examination. Because when we are talking about the 2,000 of you, it means the entire university will be paralyzed on that particular, during that particular time, and nothing else will take place. The other issue that we want also to urge you to do, if the card is starting at 7:30, ensure that you are outside the venue at 7, not inside the venue. Being inside the venue would also constitute an examination irregularity. You will stand outside, you allow the invigilators to arrange the materials, and then from there, you walk in quietly and take your seat. So don't go into the examination room unless ushered in by the invigilators. So we expect that on the 18th of next month, exactly at 7 a.m. in the morning, you are all outside your respective examination venues, which we are going to give you. We shall communicate through WhatsApp groups. We shall also communicate through your emails, your respective emails. In case you find that your number is not there or we have missed you, we shall also allocate a venue whereby any students who have not been allocated will go to. So we want this exercise to move on smoothly, and we expect you to cooperate. 7 is sharp, you are outside your respective venues, and don't go to a different venue. Because if a venue is meant for education students, and we find a law student there, that means that your paper will not be marked. Even for education student, we shall give you specific admission numbers. I hope that is very clear. Then on 25th, we shall do topic number 6, collaboration and the interpersonal skills, and probably even revise the CAT, because we intend to mark your CATs within the shortest time possible. Topic number 7, reading skills, will be covered on 1st of November. Academic writing, introduction to academic writing, will be done on 8th. Academic writing, whereby you do a number of essays, construction of paragraphs. Then in that case, staging arguments will be done on 15th. And then collaborative writing will be done on 22nd. CAT 2 may be done on 29th of November. And also cover one more other topic, acknowledging sources, references, and referencing. And we believe that by 29th, we should also do a unit recap and the closing prayer and leave you to revise for your exams. This is how we intend to cover this unit, and through your cooperation and being given good health as we have prayed for, we should be able to move even ahead of time. But remember also, out of the presentations, they are going to constitute part of your marks for the CAT. I hope if there are any issues that you are not clear, because we cannot talk directly, you are able to put them in the public chat, and our resource persons or your lecturers are picking them and we can discuss them. So basically, that is what we intend to achieve by the end of the semester. So up to that point, we shall be glad to introduce topic number 1 out of 10, Fundamentals of Communication and Collaboration, on 20th of September 2021 from 7 a.m. for 1.5 hours. Then we get into our interactive venues for those who will be having them, or tutorials, and from that 7, it will be virtual. I believe up to that point, I would like to hand over to the coordinator, Dr. Moke. If there are any issues that have been picked by students that they need clarification, please let me know so that we can handle them. And it may be also important to get one word or so from the other resource persons. Over to you, Dr. Moke.
Thank you, Dr. Mugaga, for that very elaborate introduction. It is really an eye-opener for all of us, including the students. So as I've seen numerous requests that we share what we have presented, that is assured that the slides that have been used for today's purpose will be shared via the Moodle. So before I say the final word as we close, Let me ask Dr. Eunice Musyoka if you're able to unmute and just greet the class. Okay, I'm not sure if she will manage, but Ms. Kageni, please unmute and introduce yourself.
Thank you, Daktari. Good morning, everyone. My name is Ms. Kageni. I thank God this morning that has been a wonderful presentation. And we thank God we have everyone. We thank God that we have you, and we look forward to a wonderful time together. Thank you.
Okay, thank you for that. I think I'll also invite Brian, just unmute and say hi to the class.
Yes, good morning. As you've heard, my name is Brian Mulonzi, and I'll be assisting in communication skills still. Communication is very important for human life. You need these skills to communicate with your colleagues, to communicate in wherever that you will work in the future, and to use these skills for human survival. So we will work together in this journey, and I wish you all the best. Thank you.
Yes, we also have our ICT resource person. Perhaps you can just greet the class. And one key question I've picked from the group is problem with the unit registration, problem with the portal. I may not be able to address that. Perhaps if you can just give them a word of assurance that this will be done. Maurice? Okay, I will inform the ICT team about your concerns. So with regard to unit registration, as a lecturer, I may not be able to handle, but I'll refer you to the ICT team for that. Something else that I've picked from your chat section is that you're still not sure about who will be conducting which class. And so I will take time to repeat that. I had said about this facilitation by your different lecturers before the class began, but I can do that for the sake of those who joined later. So group A is Dr. Omoke, that is the person speaking at the moment. And the groups in that group A constitute BCom, Bachelor of Economics, and Bachelor of Purchase and Supplies Management. Group B is Dr. Mugaka, Bachelor of Economics, Finance, Bachelor of Economics, Statistics, and then Bachelor of Finance. Group C, Dr. Mugaka, Bachelor of Science, IT, Bachelor of Science, Statistics, Bachelor of Science, Computer Science, and then Bachelor of Science in Business and IT, and then there's BMC. I believe that is Mathematics and Computing. That was asked, so that is BMC, Mathematics and Computing. Group D, by Dr. Eunice Musyoka, has the following courses: Nursing, Community Health, Biology. AGED is Agricultural Education, Analytical Chemistry, Industrial Chemistry, Biochem, Microbiology, Conservation, CBZ, and Library and Information Science. Group E, Ms. Kageni, which has B.Ed Science. I saw somebody not sure which group they belong to. That is Group E, by Ms. Kageni, B.Ed Science. That is Bachelor of Education, Maths, with Physics, with Chemistry, with Biology, with Computer, etc. So Bachelor of Education Science. And then Group F will be conducted by Rosalind Nyaga. That is Bachelor of Education Arts, except BEd English and Literature, which will be facilitated by Nixon Mugendi, and it will be conducted together with Law, Criminology, and then there is MPC. So I believe that one has been addressed. Something else is that some people are asking about possibility of changing their courses. I know it is possible, but I'm not able to tell you how the process takes place. That will be answered at the admissions office and then the registrar academics. So I have been informed that you will visit the admissions office. Then they'll give you a form you fill, and that your request will be evaluated, whether you qualify to that other course or not. There's a student who says that they've been given their units, BEd Arts, units that they didn't qualify to do, like there's somebody has been sent or perhaps allocated English units, yet they didn't get a C+. So that one, I would ask you to go to the school and change immediately, because for anybody to teach in any of the subjects they study with the TSC, you must have a C+ and above. Something else I've also noticed is that students are asking about other classes. I think Dr. Mugaka was very clear that all of us will be congregating every Monday from 7 to 10. We were given an assurance that for all the first year students who are struck 2021, the slot 7 to 10 on Monday is free. There's no other class. So what will happen is that we'll be taking perhaps the first hour and a half or the first 2 hours to have a common lecture. And then for those who have classes on Monday, you can be meeting your lecturers for face-to-face tutorial sessions. Please take that. It's very important that we'll have a common general lecture for everybody. And then at the second or maybe say 8:30, 9, you will be meeting your lecturers at the specific venues that have been allocated to you for tutorials, and many things will be done there. Some of them will be you presenting so that you get, you acquire these skills. It's good for me to also note here that communication skills is not about reading notes. So the notes are important, but the skills are more important than the notes, because these are like lifelong skills that you will need beyond the notes that you will have. So any activity that will be given in class will be geared towards preparing you to acquire practical communication skills, not just for you to answer examination questions. No, that is one, but also for you to be able to communicate, to solve problems, and also to come up with new ideas in very many situations. Those who have classes other days other than Monday, you will be talking to your lecturers, and the lecturers will perhaps advise on how you will be meeting, but you'll be meeting on those other days for an hour and a half or so for tutorial sessions. I think I've been able to respond to the concerns I got from the students. Yes.
Yes, Dachari, maybe if I can add something which Murimi has informed me, and I want also to pass to the students. There are two major issues which are coming up. There are a number of students who are raising issues that they don't have smartphones. That essentially means that they will not be able to follow any online teaching. And then the other one is that the bundles, it's becoming expensive. I think the university will look into all those, whereby we may probably, as we may discuss, and by next week we can communicate some kind of way forward. But what we can encourage the students, those ones who are raising issues about the bundles, please, the university expects you to be within the university compound where you are able to access the internet connectivity. So we request those ones already who have got smartphones, but they feel that the bundles are a bit, there is costly that you come to the university and get to one of those hotspots, and there are very many within the university, and attend your lectures. Number two, for those who may not be having smartphones, we know that we are challenged in different ways. We are not equally endowed, but we would like to encourage you that the future in terms of almost professional and academic development is IT-based. You will only be left behind because perhaps in the next few weeks, few years, by the time you graduate, you will be doing your work through online. You will be doing the interviews online. And they tell you to be very, so try as much as possible to acquire a smartphone, no matter how low it is in terms of when we look at its value. But it's important that we invest in education. But we understand your situation. But you can also share some of these gadgets. Go to your colleague who has got a smartphone and share. And don't miss the classes. And as we said, when you are logging in, because we are going to monitor, if you don't attain 70% of attendance of lectures, you will not be eligible to do an exam. So make sure you log in using your official name and your admission number, because that is how we are collecting the records on who has attended and who has not attended. And also during the face-to-face, you sign the forms. Thank you, coordinator.
Yes, so I think we are nearing the end of this class. There are a number of issues still being raised. To mention that AJEB is Bachelor of Education, Agriculture. So agricultural education. So there could be other combinations. So all these issues about combinations can be addressed at your departments kindly. So please reserve that question I want to say thank you so much for being patient. We had a technical hitch in the morning, but we promise that in the subsequent classes, we'll be starting on time. So always be there. And as Dr. Mugaka advised, if it's an issue with internet, please just come to the university, sit somewhere, because we have enough. That one has been catered for.